Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the second International Conference on English Language, ISEL 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin the session for this afternoon, allow me to make a few announcements. We would like everyone to take their seats as the session will begin shortly. So if everyone who's outside, can we please inform your friends and the representatives from the various state education departments to take their seats. I would also like to kindly request that you switch off your mobile phones or set them on silent mode to ensure the smooth running of the session this afternoon. And we would appreciate if you could minimize the movement within this hall throughout the session this afternoon. So once again, a very warm welcome, and we will start shortly. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. And good afternoon to all. Welcome to the second International Conference on English Language, ICEL 2022. The title for the ICEL 2022 is Envisioning the Future of English Language Education, Exploring Innovations and Best Practices in English Language Teaching. We are pleased and honored to have with us Yang Berusaha Dr. Haji Ahmad Rafi'i bin Jaib Hasim, Deputy Director General of Education Malaysia, Professional Development Sector, to deliver the keynote address for ICEL 2022. Without further ado, I would like to invite Yang Berusaha Dr. Kalminderjit Kaur Anak Perempuan Gucharan Singh, Deputy Director of English Language Teaching Centre, Ministry of Education Malaysia, to moderate the session. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome. And now, without further ado, I would like to welcome our honourable keynote speaker, Yang Berusaha Dr. Haji Ahmad Rafi'i bin Jaib Hasim, onto the stage to deliver the keynote speech. Ladies and gentlemen, let the session begin.
Hello. Good afternoon. Okay, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to all guests and participants of the second International Conference on English Language 2022. We are glad to inform you that this conference is being run on a hybrid mode, and we have participants who are following us face to face as well as through our live streaming channel DDTV. We are also proud to announce that we have participation from 7 countries besides Malaysia. These countries, ladies and gentlemen, include Vietnam, China, Pakistan, Iran, Egypt, Singapore, United Kingdom, Japan, Korea, Indonesia, Cambodia, and India. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that by now all of you are well settled in and are well prepared to participate as we take you through insightful presentations, discussions, special interest group sessions over the next 2 days. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now proceed with our first presentation and the key highlight of the second International Conference on English Language, ICEL 2022, which is the keynote address titled Sustaining Quality Education Through Professional Development, which will be delivered by Yang Bahagia, Dr. Haji Ahmad Rafi bin Sheikh Kasim, our very own Deputy Director General of Education, Professional Development Sector, Ministry of Education, Malaysia. A round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, it is critical to note the importance of professional development in relation to enhancing teacher quality. The Malaysia Education Blueprint 2013-2025 mentions that the most important school-related factor influencing student achievement is teacher quality. Thus, teachers should be supported through effective, current, innovative, and continuous professional development to assist them in improving student outcomes and to narrow the performance gap between students. Professional development also allows teachers and educators to remain competent, effective, and innovative when it comes to the skills and techniques they apply inside their classroom. Thus, we are very fortunate today to be able to explore this domain of professional development with our esteemed keynote speaker, Dr. Rafi. Allow me now to share some details about our keynote speaker, Yang Bahagia Dr. Haji Ahmad Rafi bin Sheikh Kasim. Yang Bahagia Dr. Rafi has attained a Bachelor of Science in Education degree with honours from the University of Malaya in 1993. Dr. Rafi then went on to attain his Master's in Science Management from University Utara Malaysia Kedah in 1998 and a Doctorate in Information Science and Learning Technologies, University of Missouri Columbia, USA in 2003. Yang Bahagia Dr. Ahmad Rafi started his career as a teacher in 1993 in Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Sungai Bagor, Perak. In 1998, Yang Bahagia Dr. Ahmad Rafi was appointed as a senior lecturer in Aminuddin Baki Institute, IAB. Yang Bahagia Dr. held various positions in IAB, and seeing his successful performance and leadership abilities, Dr. Ahmad Rafi was appointed as director of Aminuddin Baki Institute, Genting Highlands from 2014 to 2015. And not long after that, Yang Bahagia Dr. Ahmad Rafi was appointed as the Deputy Director of Educational Planning and Research Division from 10th April 2015 to September 2018, and later became the Director of Educational Planning and Research Division from 12 September 2018 to 8 August 2019. Being a very successful and charismatic leader, Yang Bahagia Dr. Ahmad Rafi soon received his appointment to become the Deputy Director General of Education Malaysia School Operations Division from 19 August 2019 until 22 December 2019. Currently, ladies and gentlemen, Yang Bahagia Dr. Ahmad Rafi holds the position of the Deputy Director General of Education Teacher Professional Development starting 23rd December 2019 up to now. Yang Bahagia Dr. Ahmad Rafi is also an adjunct professor at University Technology Malaysia Johor UITM starting July 2020. UTM starting 2022 July. Ladies and gentlemen, on that note, let us now welcome our keynote speaker, Dr. Haji Ahmad Rafi bin Sheikh Kasim, to deliver the ICEL 2022 keynote. Yang Bahagia Doctor, please welcome.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabi ajmain. Rabbishrahli sadri wa yassirli amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Madam Moderator, Dr. Mindy, ladies and gentlemen, Alhamdulillah, it's good to be here, and I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the English Language Teaching Center, ELTC, for organizing the second International Conference on English Language of ICEL 2022. Thank you very much to all English language practitioners out there, teachers, educators, parents, professors, and students for taking part in this annual conference. Indeed, ICEL 2022 is an excellent
platform for sharing and exchanging ideas, best practices, and innovations. As the moderator mentioned, the theme for this ICEL 2022 is envisioning the future of English language education, exploring innovation and best practices in English language teaching. The Ministry of Education Malaysia is committed in providing quality and effective professional development courses and programs to upskill teachers' competencies in tandem with global education advancement. Professional development, which is under my jurisdiction and my responsibility, is really important and is the key to sustaining quality education. Hence, the topic of my presentation today is sustaining quality education through continuous professional development, or CPD. Ladies and gentlemen, what does quality education mean, especially in this digitalized, borderless world where information is literally at one's fingertips? And how do we sustain this quality education through professional development? To ensure quality education, we need to first build quality workforce. Teachers must be given top-class education to prepare them to teach students of the 21st century the necessary skills to survive and prosper. And teachers need to be supported and encouraged to sustain quality teaching by providing them with an array of quality, effective, and practical CPDs or courses. We can make sure that teaching profession become the profession of choice in this country. The Malaysian Education Blueprint, or MEB 2013-2025, is a 12-year blueprint that outlines the vision of the education system in Malaysia. It provides a comprehensive plan for sustainable transformation of our education system. This transformation includes putting in place relevant and ongoing professional development program to enhance the quality of teachers and school leaders in the system. We recognize that the school leaders and teachers are the most important school-based drivers of student outcomes. Hence, in-service training and professional development are key factors in sustaining the quality of education in the school system. Bahagian Profesionalisme Guru, or the Teacher Professionalism Division, or BPG, has developed a comprehensive plan for ongoing professional development for teachers and school leaders. The plan is developed to ensure that all teachers and school leaders are involved in continuous professional development to improve on their knowledge, skills, and competencies in keeping with new development in the world. The comprehensive professional development plan includes maintaining and sustaining the quality of English language education in Malaysia. To support the idea behind the Malaysian Education Blueprint 2013-2025, we have also developed the English Roadmap back in 2015. And along the same line, we have adopted the Common European Framework of Reference for Languages, or CEFR, that underpin the transformation of English language education in Malaysia. This move is to ensure that the teaching of English language is on par with international standards. Continuous professional development for all English language teachers, for CEFR-aligned curriculum, teaching and learning, as well as assessment, are ongoing to strengthen the teaching practices in the language classroom. Ladies and gentlemen, are we positioning our professional development plan in accordance with the global need and growth? Let's look at other countries and how they do it to make sure they can all time, making sure that all teachers upheld the same level of quality. If you look at Singapore, Hong Kong, Australia, and Japan, there are comprehensive plans developed to ensure professional development among teachers. In Singapore, for example, which is one of the top performing countries in education, the Ministry of Education of Singapore provides resources and training to meet at least 100 voluntary hours professional development per year. There are three main professional development providers in Singapore: the National Institute of Education, the Academy of Singapore Teachers, and six centers of excellence. And the school themselves are responsible for the professional development. Guided by the teacher model growth, the teacher growth model, these providers aim at making PD or professional development coherent with teachers' interests, the needs of schools, and the national curriculum. So in Malaysia, we have our Standard Guru Malaysia, or SGM, which is our own initiative which outlines the guideline for professional development at different levels. The document focuses on four domains: knowledge orientation, instructional development, community involvement, and the development of personal qualities. Various initiatives are taken to ensure teacher professional growth, such as the PD platform. We also have System Pengurusan Latihan KPM, or SPL-KPM, an integrated micro-learning program with robust virtual experience, or IMPROVE, where these are the CPD platforms which offer courses that are aligned to teachers' interests and requirements. To date, there are 98,000 CPD courses, both local and international courses in SPL-KPM. A total of 428,388 course participants are actively participating in the courses offered. The IMPROVE platform has to date almost 70,000 teachers registered for online courses, and this is a positive sign for our teachers in Malaysia. Ladies and gentlemen, Malaysia recognizes that we need to collaborate internationally as our concerted effort to enhance teacher quality. We have strong partnership with countries like Korea, South Korea, and Japan. The Korean-Malaysian Teacher Exchange Program, or COMTEP, is a perfect example of professional international cooperation. In 2003, Japan initiated a new professional development system under which all teachers with 10 years of experience receive training according to their individual abilities and aptitudes in areas such as course instruction and student guidance. Local boards of education offer courses and workshops to improve teachers' instructional abilities to help teachers develop educational knowledge that is useful for instruction. The Japan International Cooperative Agency, or JICA, offers scholarships for teachers and officers to enhance their professional skills. Through these programs, our teachers get the opportunity to upgrade their teachers and knowledge. In Malaysia, we have a comprehensive plan for our professional development as outlined in the MEB. Under Shift 4 of the MEB, we assert that the transformation of teaching into a profession of choice is by having good, high-quality CPDs through network of peers, including teacher coaches, senior teachers, and principal, to disseminate best practices. Training is focused to allow teachers to continuously build their skill level against each of the competencies expected of teachers. Our CPD is implemented by various institutions such as the ELTC, the IPGM, the IAB, and at the state level by the State Education Department and the District Education Departments. The English Language Teaching Center, or ELTC, is mandated by the Ministry of Education to carry out continuous professional development, or CPD, courses for in-service English language teachers nationwide. The professional upskilling of English language teachers, or PRO-ELT, and ELT micro-credentials for professional development training to local and international ESL teachers and ELT practitioners are example of the CPD courses. This comprehensive plan for professional development aims to raise the bar for professionalism standards of pre-service and in-service teachers. Ladies and gentlemen, to support CPD, we have a plan to enhance the digitalization of education, as also proposed in MEB Shift 7. In line with the digitalization of education, ELTC began offering micro-credentials for professional development training to local and international ESL teachers and ELT practitioners via the Improve platform. These micro-credentials, known as Improve CREDs, are standalone courses which enhance growth mindset towards competency-based professional development. Combined with a unique EdTech integration model based on TPEC framework, Improve CREDs allow participants to customize the professional development training to meet their personal learning needs. The Institute of Teacher Education Malaysia, or IPGM, take charge of the 27 teacher training institutes throughout Malaysia. IPGM has several courses for in-service teachers aimed for the professional development. And similarly, Institute Aminuddin Baki, or IAB, which is a 43-year-old institution for leadership and management training for Malaysia, provides upskilling courses for professional development among leaders. To date, more than 10,000 school leaders have completed the National Professional Qualification for Educational Leaders, or NPQL, leadership training provided by IAB. And they also provide a lot of training courses for middle and senior leadership positions throughout our school system, our district education office, our state education office, as well as those in the Ministry of Education. And I would like to take this opportunity to share some reports and findings for all of us to rethink and perhaps be guided by the findings to trigger the discussion and deliberation during this conference. The OECD Teaching and Learning International Survey, or TALIS 2021, reported that 94% of teachers across the OECD countries participated in continuous professional development activities over the past 12 months. Through the professional development activities, the teachers have shown credibility through innovations and best practices. This finding shows that investment in teachers is needed to develop capacity in understanding individual students' needs and tailor their learning strategies accordingly. And in Malaysia, we have set the bar at a higher rate, whereby it is a must for all teachers, all educators, to go through that professional learning program for at least for 5 days. And so far, we have managed to fulfill that requirement. Congratulations to the teachers and educators from Malaysia. In PISA 2018, reading literacy is defined as students' capacity to understand, use, evaluate, reflect on, and engage with text to achieve one's goal, develop one's knowledge and potential, and participate in society. In 2018, Malaysia's average score for reading literacy was 415, which is still below the OECD average. And we know that we need to work harder to instill the skill and the culture of reading in this country. And I strongly believe the English teachers especially will be the best people to make sure that we can achieve this goal. The PISA 2018 result showed that when students were confronted with literacy tasks that required them to understand implicit cues to pertaining to the content or the source of information, an average of just 9% of the 15-year-old students in OECD countries had enough of a reading proficiency level to be able to successfully distinguish facts from opinion. And this data does not differ much if we look back at the PISA 2012, 2015, and also 2018. So it reminds us that there's a lot more to be done, especially by the language teachers, be it in Malay language or English. So we need to work harder to instill reading culture and the ability to understand. And we know that reading literacy is critical for students to successfully complete basic education. And it is timely for us to find new approaches or strategies to develop reading literacy. Then I believe, and I strongly believe, that should be one of the focus of this conference. Ladies and gentlemen, though there are challenges that we need to face, there are success stories that all of us can be proud of. The MOE have seen teachers thriving in this digital age. Our teachers are never short of creativity and innovations in bringing the best strategies into the language classroom to make learning more fun and meaningful. And I'm proud to highlight some of the successful innovation and creative practices by our Malaysian school teachers. The names of teachers that I'm announcing are in no order of rank of achievement. And I would like to start with an English teacher. Cikgu Ahmad Syarul Ahzan Ibrahim, or better known as Sir Asai, who is currently serving in SMK Long Gafar 2, Kota Baru, took to social media to make learning English fun. Sir Asai creates and posts short, impactful videos on TikTok to encourage his students to have fun while learning English. To date, Sir Asai has approximately 420,000 followers on TikTok. Congratulations, Sir Asai. Next, Cikgu Muhammad Khalifah Muhammad Afnan, who hails from Keningau Vocational College in Sabah. He is the recipient of the 2022 Cambridge Dedicated Teacher Award. He initiated a Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics, or STEM, project where he trains students in robotics, drones, coding and other technology-based disciplines. Cikgu Muhammad Al-Khalifah's effort to elevate the image of vocational education is a very noble cause. The Teachers' Day National Celebration 2022 have acknowledged and awarded numerous teachers under the Creative and Innovative Teachers Awards category. Ladies and gentlemen, Darling Hammond states that students learn as much from a teacher as from a teacher. The impact of a teacher on student learning is great. Now let us highlight the outcomes of our CPD initiatives. Students in Malaysian education systems have received many outstanding achievements. Allow me to highlight some of these achievements. We start with Mariam Muzami, an 11-year-old Standard 5 student from SK Perempuan Methodist Kuantan, who won 2 gold medals at the Creation, Innovation, Technology and Research Exposition in 2020 and 2021. Mariam received both local and international accolades for inventing sustainable livestock feed. Next, Adik Arif Hazim bin Yazri, a 10-year-old student from SK Gong Badak, Kuala Nerus, Terengganu, began creating pautun for the teaching of science since 2019. And then the students from SMJK Catholic Petaling Jaya, who won the first Grand Award in Robotics and Intelligent Machines European Union Contest for Young Scientists Grand Award in 2021. These are some of the success stories that highlight the creativity and innovations by teachers and students in our education system. Indeed, we can see that our CPD initiatives have been successfully and we are developing towards meeting the global needs. Before I end my presentation today, I would like to leave all of you with 3 pertinent points to ponder throughout this conference. Firstly, what do we envision the future of English language education to be like? Secondly, how do we sustain the quality of English language teaching? And thirdly, what are the future and new skills that English language teachers need? The cornerstone to sustain quality education is continuous professional development. CPD must be relevant to the current and future demands of the education landscape. Teachers and ELT practitioners must be lifelong learners, adaptable, and be equipped with future-proof skills to impact student learning. With that, I wish all of you every success as you engage in this 3-day conference. Thank you very much. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Yang Bahagia, Doctor, for delivering a detailed and insightful keynote, lining out the various efforts and provisions that are being initiated by the Ministry of Education Malaysia to ensure teachers in Malaysia receive quality professional development courses at par with international standards. We sincerely hope that teachers will continue to access these professional development courses being provided by various institutions to continue to build their competencies and pedagogies. The MOE is highly committed to ensure that ELT teachers also enhance their digital skills in teaching and learning to meet the demands of current times. Ladies and gentlemen, at the same time, I would also like to highlight that we have 13 booths who are exhibiting their work, their efforts in schools through the highly immersive program. And I would like to invite each and every one of you to visit these booths and to see what teachers and students are doing, the wonderful activities, the impactful tasks that students are doing under the highly immersive program. We are committed and we call for all teachers to also be committed to enhancing yourselves, to upskilling yourselves, so that Malaysia is able to produce quality teachers who stand along with all other teachers from all other international countries globally. Thank you very much, Yang Bahagia, Dr. Rafi, for the wonderful speech that was delivered. So we come to the end of the keynote speech of the ICEL 2022. And with this, we have come to the next event. I would like to invite all of you for a short tea break before we meet again in this same ballroom for the next event, which is the first plenary session for the day. Ladies and gentlemen, with that, I bid you thank you.